Today I want to show you how to create an interactive network using the R programming language. And as an example, we will visualize the Marvel Cinematic Universe. I will show you the full process of the data analysis. So first we will begin by scrapping the data on Wikipedia, cleaning it, do some exploratory analysis, and then finally I will show you how to create an interactive network and how to customize it. And as always, if you want to get the code of this tutorial, you can go on my website on felixanalytics.com. And once you subscribe to my newsletters, you will receive an automatic email from me with the URL of my GitHub account. That being said, let's get started.
All right. So now we are in RStudio. So as always, the first thing we want to do is to install the necessary R packages for this analysis. So we will use the Tidyverse. So it's a collection of packages to do data wrangling or visualization. RVest to do web scrapping in a tidy way. Tidygraph to do network analysis also in a tidy way. And VisNetwork, which will allow us to make this interactive network visualization. So first we want to access the data. So I looked a bit online and I found that we'll have nice tables on Wikipedia. So here are the three links for each phases of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. So let's have a look at it. And as you can see here, we have the old ID, which is a permanent link. So As you know, Wikipedia allows the changes, but with this link, you will have the same version as I have. So if we open this page and we scroll down, you will see the wiki table that I want to scrap. So we have the main characters and we have the name of the movies in which each character has been. So the idea here is to take this data and transform it in a tidy structure, meaning each variable has a column. So we will have a character variable, a movie variable, and an actor variable. And what we want here, for example, for Iron Man, is have missing values for each character that are not in the movie. So for example, here, Hulk was not in the movie Iron Man, but it was in the Incredible Hulk movie. This tutorial is not about web scrapping, but I will anyway show you very quickly how to do that. So you can right click and click on inspect. And with Wikipedia, it's quite easy. You can select the class, wiki table class, I think. And you will use reverse to scrap only the table from this specific class here, wiki table. And we will do that for each link. All of them have a table with the same structure. Back to R now. So we will take the three URL. So here in URLs, we have the three URLs. We want to do the scrapping. And here we will create a function that will extract the specific table from this page. So we have the URL. We will read this HTML page. We take all the nodes that have the class wiki table, then extract this all the tables using the HTML underscore table function from RVest with the empty characters as NAs. And we will take the third table because we have two other tables before it. So it's the third table of this specific Wikipedia page. This will allow us to download the data as such as a data frame. And now we want to pivot it using the pivot longer function with the movie and the actor as variables for the names and the values. We'll do some regular expressions to remove and clean the actor names as well as the character names. And we will also add specific spaces if needed. I don't want to go deep further in it. If you're interested, you can let me know in the comments. I can make a specific video about web scrapping or regular expressions using R. But I think that's mostly it. Just download this code, play with it if you want to dig further and ask me questions if you do in the comments below. So once we have created this function, we will use it to loop on each URL using the map underscore dfr function from the per package. And we will call this function on each of the URLs. So we have here three URLs. And this function will also join or merge these three data frames into a single one. So let's do this. And now, if we look at this df object, we will see we have all our data in a nicely tidy way with NAs when the character is not in a specific movie. So here, again, Hulk is not in Iron Man, but It is, of course, in the movie The Incredible Hulk. We also need to do some additional cleaning because there is a C that comes after the name of the character. So let me show you that. Sometimes we have this little C over here that indicates an uncredited cameo role, meaning the character appears but very briefly in the movie. So this can be a bit annoying. That's not the idea I have here because we have even more characters. So let's remove that. So we can remove this by detecting the C at the end. This is a regular expression to say this is the dollar sign, meaning that the C comes at the end of the string. When we detect that, we will replace it as an NA character. Also removing other information about it and renaming the name of the movie that have the same name as the characters, because we don't want to have the character name that have the same name as the movie. So that's why I decided to rename the Thor movies as Thor 1 to differentiate from the Thor character. On Iron Man the movie, the number 1, I called it Iron Man 1 to distinguish it from the Iron Man character, Tony Stark. Here, then, it's an important phase. We want to remove all the characters that are not appearing in the movies. So now, with our clean data set, we have a table of 202 observations for each characters appearing in each movie. And what we want to do now is a very quick exploratory data analysis, just to show you that it's easy to do also using the tidygraph R package. So we can count the most recurring character using the CAN function here. So we see that it's Captain America and Iron Man in our dataset that are appearing the most in 9 different movies. What about the movie with the most characters? It's of course the 2 Avengers movie that are the movies where all the different characters from different movies are together. Now I just want to show you also how we can use different tricks using the tidygraph R package. And to do that, we will have to transform our data frame as a table graph using the asTableGraph function from the tidygraph package. Here we have our table graph with nodes on edges, giving here our different information about it. It's a table graph object, but it's also an iGraph object coming from another R package called iGraph. Actually, the tidygraph R package allows to use the function from the iGraph R package within the tidyverse ecosystem. A tidygraph is a wrapper of the iGraph functions. For example, the tidygraph R package allows to easily get centrality metrics such as degree, betweenness, closeness, etc. You can even access a variety of different metrics, such as the PageRank algorithm originally used by Google, for example. Now that we have our table graph object called network, we can analyze the nodes. So by activating the nodes over here, let's say, for example, we want to call centrality degree metrics. That allows us to know which are the characters that are the most central. So if we run this code again, we have actually the same thing as we have by counting the number of characters. We see that the numbers of degrees for Iron Man and Captain America are 9, but exactly as expected. I will not go further into the different metrics of the tidygraph. Could do another video if you're interested in, but you can explore also by yourself. We will add an additional group variable, which will allow us to visualize differently the Marvel characters on the movies in the networks. And we can pipe this to this network data function to create an object called thisNetwork that can be read by the thisNetwork function to create the visualization. Finally, we can create this interactive network by adding the nodes from thisNetwork to the nodes argument, the edges to edges. You can show the width, the height, and even give it a title. Here I said the title will be the Marvel Cinematic Universe Network. We'll give it a random seed because the network is generated in a random way. So let's begin by just running this. On here, as you can see, we have our first network with in yellow the movies and in blue the different characters. One of the good things about this is fully customizable using different commands. So for example, I decided to add some icons to make it more clear which are the movies and which are the characters. So to do that, we will call the add from onSome function. Using our group column we just built previously, we can now customize the nodes, and we will say that the group name is the movie. We want the shape as icons, and here we want to have the icon as a dark blue, and each icon number code is related to a specific icon. F008 is the number code for the icon film, and F007 is the icon name for the user icon. I did the same with the character that I will see in red. So if I call this, you will see now that this is the icon that is identified by F008, and F007 is its person. I also want to highlight the nearest edges on nodes when hovering my mouse on a node. So this can be done very easily with the function this option. As you can see, the parameters should be inserted inside a list, as the thisNetwork function transforms the parameters into JSON structure. You can also add navigation buttons simply by adding them using the thisInteraction function. And now let's play a bit with our interactive network. Make it bigger. Here you can see it. So these are the navigation options you can use. And you can zoom using this, or you can use your mouse. And if I looked, for example, for Iron Man, Tony Stark Iron Man over here, it will appear. And we can move it, and you will see with the highlight nearest function in which movies he has been. And we can do that for each characters.
Well, I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, consider giving me a like or even subscribe. And if you want to get the full code of this tutorial, you can go on my website on felixanalytics.com. And I see you in another tutorial. Take care. Bye bye.